Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now, in continuation of our discussion regarding the drugs acting on autonomic nervous system, now we are going to start with the drugs acting on the sympathetic nervous system or the adrenergic nervous system. And for obviously, for that purpose, we must have concepts of sympathomimetics for the better understanding of this chapter. For your convenience, as usual, we have divided it into two parts. Now, first of all, today we are going to have the first part of discussion regarding concept of sympathetic nervous system. Now, sympathomimetics. As the word is showing it, the mimetic means mimic, resemble. So these are the drugs, are the agonist when we give them inside the body. So obviously, they bind to the respective receptor, that is adrenergic alpha beta receptor, and they activate them, and accordingly they will produce effects which will mimic or resemble to the natural sympathetic nervous system stimulation. Now again, let's have some revision of our previous discussion of the introductory aspect. Now, this diagram is indicating synthesis of neurotransmitters. As the diagram is showing is, norepinephrine is the main neurotransmitter in case of sympathetic nervous system in the nerve ending. So it is synthesized and stored inside the nerve ending, and action potential comes, this norepinephrine released inside the synapse, and here this release norepinephrine, mainly it is reuptaken. The major end of this release norepinephrine is the reuptake. But the remaining part of the norepinephrine, which has not yet reuptaken, that will go and bind to the receptor, especially the postsynaptic receptor present on the organs. Here, alpha beta receptor. Or they may even bind to the presynaptic receptor, which are usually alpha 2 receptor. So, when we give agonists, they will bind to the same alpha beta receptor to which the natural norepinephrine is binding. So when they will bind, they will activate these receptors, and obviously they will produce the effect which resembles to the sympathetic stimulus, that is sympathomimetic effect. Usually these drugs act and bind directly to the receptor, and they will are known as direct sympathomimetics. Second group is indirectly acting drugs. Now, indirectly acting drugs, they act in two ways. One is they may block the reuptake, which is the major part of the release norepinephrine. So all the release norepinephrine is available in synapse, and there is increased concentration of norepinephrine available to bind with the alpha beta receptor. So what happens due to increased available norepinephrine concentration, we bind receptor and they will produce the effects, sympathomimetic effects, and this is one A of indirectly acting sympathomimetics. Now, there is another way to show the indirect effect, and that is the drugs, they enhance the release of norepinephrine from the stored vesicles, and more neurotransmitter norepinephrine is available in the synapse to bind with the receptor and show the sympathomimetic effect. So direct we have already discussed, but there are some agents which show the mixed types of effects. Okay, not only they release the stored norepinephrine, but they also can bind directly to the receptors and show their effects. So in this way, we have mainly two types of sympathomimetics, directly acting and sympathomimetic, but there are some drugs which have mixed activity also. Now remember, when adrenergic receptors, they are activated, first of all, endogenously by the release neurotransmitters, norepinephrine. So obviously they will stimulate the sympathetic nervous system. Or this sympathetic stimulation may be done exogenously by the drugs or the agonist or even partial agonist, and they will also show the sympathomimetic activity. In a disease related to sympathetic nervous system, obviously their disease may be either decrease or increase activity of the sympathetic nervous system. So if activity is decreased, So obviously there will be decreased level of norepinephrine. So the answer is increase the level of norepinephrine. And in this way we can increase the activity. So usually we give then sympathetic mimetic drugs. They will bind to the receptor and they will increase the adrenergic activity. On the other hand, if the activity is increased, that means due to increased level of norepinephrine, here the answer will be try to decrease the level of norepinephrine or decrease the activity. So decreased activity is done by giving adrenergic blocker, what we may call as sympatholytics. But for the time being, we are considering only the sympathomimetics. Now sympathetic stimulation, whether through endogenously released norepinephrine or exogenously through the agonist, main thing is there is cardiac stimulation. Remember one, main activity is cardiac stimulation. Now this cardiac stimulation will obviously vary depending upon the intensity of the stimulation, whether endogenously or exogenously. So if there is increased stimulation, increased cardiac stimulation. Moderate, moderate stimulation. Slight, slight cardiac stimulation. First indication of cardiac stimulation is there is increase in heart rate, what we call it as positive chronotropic effect, chrono, number. So positive chronotropic means increased heart rate. That is the first thing which we observe as a sign of cardiac stimulation. Second is increased force of contraction, what we call as positive inotropic effect. Now, from our knowledge of physiology, we know cardiac output that is depending upon the heart rate and to stroke volume. So when we multiply these two factors, heart rate and stroke, so obviously there will be increased cardiac output. So obviously stroke volume itself depends upon the force of contraction. So in this way, when there is cardiac stimulation, there is increased cardiac output also. So increased cardiac output will add to increase in blood pressure, because we know blood pressure is a product of cardiac output and perfusion. So if there is only increase in cardiac output, there will be increase in systolic part of blood pressure. But if there is increase in peripheral resistance, that will add to the increase in diastolic part of the blood pressure also. The peripheral resistance we will discuss later on, but we know from our knowledge of physiology that peripheral resistance depends upon the tone of the arterioles. So if there is vasoconstriction of the arterioles, there will be increased peripheral resistance and there will be increased diastolic blood pressure part. So due to all these increased heart rate, increased stroke volume, increased force of contraction and increased cardiac output, workload on the heart is increased. And that will require increased oxygen supply, because there's increased oxygen requirement due to increased workload. That is the first effect which we must remember due to increased cardiac stimulation, that is increased oxygen requirement. This increased oxygen requirement may produce problem in case of ischemic patient, and they may precipitate the attacks of angina in such patients. There is third activity also. First two were positive chronotropic, positive inotropic, and third one is positive bromotropic. But that is increased conduction of the impulse from one place to another, from SA node to AV node, or all the parts of atria, or from AV node to ventricles or parts. So in such, if there is increased conduction, there are chances of suffering from arrhythmias. That is the second result. Now the structure-active relationship, that means how changes in the drug activity may occur with the changes in the molecular structure of that drug. Now this is very important, frequently ask question in the university exam, structure activity relationship. Now this is the basic or the parent molecule of all the sympathomimetic drugs, phenylethylamine, which itself actually consists of two parts, One is benzene ring and second is ethylamine chain. So modification in the phenylethylene molecule by baking substitution at the level of benzene ring or at the level of beta chain, alpha chain, we may affect or we may produce changes in the affinity for the receptor binding or for the activity or what we call as intrinsic activity of the drugs. So changes in at all these three effects may produce changes in the activity or affinity of the sympathetic myobatric drugs. Now, substitution at the level of benzene ring, remember, will produce the changes in the pharmacodynamic and the pharmacokinetic activity of the drugs, of the sympathetic mimetics. While substitution at the level of beta or alpha chain in this amine chain will produce the changes in the affinity for the receptor, affinity for the particular receptor alpha or beta. Now this benzene ring here is actually a specific one. It is known as catechol ring if hydroxyl ion is present at the level of 3 and 4 positions. So catechol ring means benzene ring with OH ion at the level of 3 or 4 position. So all those drugs which are having this catechol ring are known as catechol amine. Examples are epinephrine, hydroxyl at the level 3 and 4, norepinephrine 3 and 4, dopamine 3 and 4, isoproterenol 3 and 4. So all are containing catechol rings. So these are catechol amines. While the non-catechol amines are those types of sympathetic mimetics in which their chemical molecule are not having any catechol ring. For example, in case of phenylephrine, hydroxyl ion is absent at the level of 4. Methoxamine also having no support but substitution of some other group instead of this hydroxyl. In case of ephedrine, both absent, amphetamine both absent, but obviously there are some changes at the level of amine chain also. That is why they are having different structure. So if there is absence of hydroxyl ion either at the one or the both position of benzene ring, they may affect the pharmacodynamic and pharmacokinetic activity of the drug. While if there is substitution, especially at the level of alpha chain, they may produce the prolongation of the duration of action. They have prolonged duration of action if there is any change at the level of alpha position. So now we will have some break and then we will continue with the remaining aspect of the concepts of sympathetic mimetic. Thank you very much.